friends, I'm Dr. Shagida, Department of Biochemistry, Centers of College of Arts and Science, Kadalur. I'm going to talk about structure of proteins. Proteins are most abundant organic molecule present within the cells. It performs varieties of function in human body. It may be divided into structural and dynamic. Protein actors are enzyme, immunoglobulin, blood clotting factors, membrane receptors, genetic control, muscle contraction, and respiration. Protein is present in every part of our body like skin, muscle, inner organs, blood, and bones. The structure of protein composed of four different levels: primary structure, secondary structure, tertiary, and quaternary structure. Primary structure is the linear sequence of amino acids forming the backbones of protein. Secondary structure, the spatial arrangement of protein by twisting of polypeptide chain. Tertiary structure, the three-dimensional structure of the functional protein. Quaternary structure, some of the protein composed of two or more polypeptide chain. This known as subunit. The spatial arrangement of this subunit is known as quaternary structure of proteins. Proteins play a vital role in human body. Now, we can see about the introduction and structure of proteins. There are three macronutrients present in our food. They are protein, fats, and carbohydrate. Macronutrients provide calories. The body requires large amount of macronutrients to sustain the life. Each gram of protein contains 4 calories. Chemically, protein is composed of amino acid, which are organic compound made of carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, and oxygen. Amino acids are building blocks of proteins. It is the chain of amino acid joined by peptide bond in a specific sequences. It is essential nutrient. There is no life without proteins. It contain every part of our body: the skin, muscle, hair, blood, and bones. It is the polymer of L amino acid. 300 different amino acid occurs in nature. Only 20 amino acids are standard amino acid, which participate in the structure of proteins, isolated from different forms of life. The universal nature of genetic code available for the incorporation of only 20 amino acid when the proteins are synthesized in the cells. Amino acids are organic compound that contain amino and carboxyl group. It is a building blocks of proteins. Next, we can see about the functions of proteins. Functions of proteins. Protein is primarily used in the body to build, maintain, and repair body tissues. It is the major source of energy. Protein produce enzymes that increase the rate of chemical reaction in the body. It help mediate cell responses. Protein transports small molecule through the organisms. Example, hemoglobin is a protein that transport oxygen to the cells, and it is called as transport protein. Protein act as antibodies. It help to prevent infection, illness, and disease. It make up large protein of muscle fiber and help in the movement of various parts of our bodies. Next, we can see about peptides. When the amino group of one amino acid is combined to the carboxyl group of another amino acid is known as peptide bond. Polypeptide. A protein containing more than one peptide chain is known as polypeptide chain. Now, we can see about the structure of proteins. Structure of proteins is differentiated into 4 different types: primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary structure. This slide shows the primary structure of protein. The linear sequence of amino acid forming the backbones of protein is known as primary structure of proteins. Primary structure of protein determined by 3 different ways: determination of amino acid composition, degradation of protein or polypeptide into smaller fragments, determination of amino acid sequences. First, we can see about determination of amino acid composition. protein is completely hydrolyzed to liberate the amino acid, which are quantitatively estimated. Hydrolysis may be carried out by using acid, alkali or enzyme treatment. The prolase is a non-specific proteolytic enzyme that causes complete hydrolysis of proteins. The liberation of amino acid from protein can be determined by chromatography techniques. Next, we can see about the degradation of protein or polypeptide into smaller fragments. Depend on three different steps: liberation of polypeptide, number of polypeptide, breakdown of polypeptide into smaller fragments. First one, liberation of polypeptide. By using urea or quinidine hydrochloride, it disturbs the non-covalent bond present in the protein and dissociate protein into polypeptide chains. Next, number of polypeptide by using diacyl chloride. Breakdown of polypeptide into fragment by two method: enzymatic method and then chemical cleavage method. In the enzymatic method, we use trypsin, chymotrypsin and pepsin. In chemical cleavage, we use cyanogen bromide. We split the polypeptide into smaller fragments. Next, determination of amino acid sequences. Determination of amino acid sequences by using Sanger and Edman reagents. Next, we can see about the secondary structure of proteins. It depends on two types: alpha helix and then beta sheets. Now, alpha helix. Pauling and Corey proposed the alpha helix. There are 3.6 amino acid residue present in per turn of alpha helix. Distance travelled by turn is 0.5 nanometer. It is stabilized by hydrogen bonds. Right-handed helix is more stable than the left-handed helix. Next, we can see about the beta bleated sheet. Pauling and Corey proposed the beta sheet, composed of two or more segments of fully extended polypeptide chain. In beta sheet and the adjacent polypeptide chain run in opposite direction, the structure is termed as anti-parallel beta sheet. Region of beta sheet are present in many proteins and both parallel and anti-parallel in nature. Next, tertiary structure of proteins. The globular protein is completely composed of series of single helix. The three dimension is maintained by covalent, hydrogen, disulfide, hydrophobic, nonpolar bond and ionic bonds. Example, myoglobin. Myoglobin molecular weight is 16,700. It is an iron containing protein acting as a storehouse of oxygen to the muscles. It contains single polypeptide chain of 153 amino acid. The tertiary structure of the myoglobin, a very compact structure with little space which can accommodate only 4 water molecules. Next, we can see about the quaternary structure of proteins. In the quaternary structure of proteins, majority of proteins are composed of single polypeptide chain. Some of the protein consists of 2 or more polypeptide chain. Such protein is known as quaternary structure of proteins. Example, hemoglobin. It is a protein consists of 4 polypeptide chain. There are 2 types, 2 alpha chain and 2 beta chain. The alpha chain has valine at N-terminal end and arginine at the carboxy terminal end, and it contains 141 amino acid residues. The beta chain has valine at amino terminal end and histidine at carboxy terminal end, and it contains 146 amino acid residues. So, the protein has total 574 amino acid residue in its structure. The alpha and beta structure held it together as a pair of ionic and hydrogen bond. The two pairs are then joined with each other by additional ionic bond, hydrogen and hydrophobic bonds. Thus, the 4 subunits fit together to produce the quaternary structure of hemoglobin. Thank you.